been shared to the group. All right, so good morning. If you guys are traveling, you're getting ready to travel for the holidays, right? You're going to be going to visit your family in different parts of the country. You're going to be in the car. You're going to be driving back and forth to grandmother's house. And you want to know what to take with you in the car so that you don't ruin everything you've done to get yourself. Oh, by the way, do you love my shirt? I got this on a float trip when I was in Missouri right before I left town. So it's my love shirt. But what can you take with you in the car to keep you from breaking your diet as you're traveling, getting ready for the holidays, getting ready to go do things, or if you're just going on vacation, what is it that you can take with you in the car? So of course, we're talking basically a keto lifestyle, trying to avoid things like carbohydrates, breads, biscuits and gravy, muffins, things like that, that you get in a gas station when you're hungry because you just didn't pre-plan, right? So let's plan your next vacation, your next road trip to make sure that you have the things that you need. First of all, there's things you can take that do not require a cooler, but if you have one of those little coolers, like a six-pack cooler, you can put some cool stuff in there to take with you. And if you're in a hurry and you don't want to stop a lot, it's really good to have some snacks in the car so that you don't have to stop at every single gas station that you go by. Hey, Jim, as long as you're not driving, you can use vodka. But if you're the driver, you should probably not use vodka. Thanks for your input there. But, of course, take bottled water with you, of course, in the car. Always make sure you have bottled water. And clean water is one of the best things that you can do. Bring some sea salt or some different flavors, like, you know, maybe even if you don't care for water much, bring some lemons that you can slice up, put them in a Ziploc bag, stuff one inside your water bottle, or limes. I personally prefer limes over lemons, so I do that myself frequently. But you can also get those little cheese sticks that are individually packaged. You can throw those in the cooler. Even if you have some ice in there, they won't be damaged by the water because they're individually packaged. So individual cheese sticks, or if you're on a budget and you don't want to do that, just bring some hard cheese that you can slice up and put it in a Ziploc bag and bring that with you. You can also do things like beef jerky, meat sticks. You can also bring like deer jerky or deer sticks. I know a lot of people love those. And you can also do things like individually packed almonds. I like the chocolate dusted almonds. I get them from Walgreens, the best one. They're the lowest carb ones I've found. I usually have to order them online from the Walgreens store because they don't always have them in the store, but they are low carb. They're super good and they get rid of your chocolate fix. They fix your chocolate fix. So those are always nice to have around. Other things, macadamia nuts. You can get mixed nuts. Just make sure you don't get the trail mix that has the M&Ms and stuff in it, because that kind of defeats the whole purpose. But if you really are a chocolate junkie and you must have some chocolate, get some of that dark chocolate that's like 70, 80, 90% dark chocolate. It's really bitter, but if you eat it with something else, like nuts, it's not so bitter and it makes things a little easier for you to travel. So traveling can be a bit of a challenge sometimes, especially if you have a long road trip ahead of you. But if you're eating and snacking in the car, it will keep you from stopping at like the Cracker Barrel or the Steak and Shake or Taco Bell and grabbing something in a hurry and haste because you're hungry and you don't want to like stop at a restaurant or whatever. If you have some snacks in the car, then you'll be less likely to do that. And if you're drinking water, I know water makes you have to go to the bathroom, but if you put lemon and lime in it, it will make that less happen less, because the minerals in the lemons and limes actually help your cells uptake the water. So it doesn't make you have to go to the bathroom as frequently, because you're actually getting the benefit out of that water because it's getting into your cells instead of just kind of running straight through. So that's a little tip for you to have. But anyway, if you plan ahead, I mean, honestly, the biggest thing you can do as far as road trips go is plan ahead a little bit and think about the things that you can take with you to snack on that will keep you from making poor decisions as you're walking through that truck stop looking for the bathroom. So if you're planning a trip, planning a road trip, planning even on a plane, I always take my own snacks And I always stop after I get through security and purchase a bottle of water. Typically, it's so that I can mix up one of my little drinks, but I will drink the water and then I will make myself a drink when I get on the plane, just so that I have my ketones going for me while I'm going. But once you get through security, you can purchase a bottle of water, but you're allowed to bring your own nuts, peanuts, which I don't really recommend, because the snacks that they give you on a plane, you never really know for sure what kind of a snack you're going to get. It might be pretzels. It might be honey roasted peanuts. It might be something like that. And if you're really doing a strict ketogenic diet, you want to have control over what you're putting in your body, right? So you can't bring any liquids, but you can bring snacks. You can bring meat sticks on the plane with you. So just plan ahead so that you have some stuff with you in your carry-on bag that you have access to if you just by chance would get hungry, or if the person sitting next to you is eating something that smells really good and you need a little something to offset the jealousy from the guy next to you. Just bring your own snacks. And I know most people don't think about that. I see people all the time in airports that just, they're not planning ahead. So they're sitting in the airport bar or the airport restaurant, and there's sometimes not all that great of options, right? Because those places don't have full menus sometimes. So you end up eating French fries or some sort of prepackaged salad that has God knows what in it. And I'm not saying they have bad food, because I eat at airports frequently. You just have to be prepared, and you have to know that sometimes you have to make choices that are not necessarily congruent with your lifestyle. So hopefully this was helpful. If it was, please comment below, what's your favorite airport food and what's your favorite road trip food? What do you take with you? If you're one of those people that does plan ahead, what do you take with you? Because I'm sure other people would love to know what it is that you're taking with you on your trips that might be beneficial for them. So let's share with each other what it is that we take. Personally, I always take some mixed nuts and water, and I try to avoid buying things at gas stations and stuff, just to keep myself on track. So plan your meals, plan your snacks, make sure that you have things that will keep you satisfied so that you're not accidentally like grabbing something on the spur of the moment. So I hope this was helpful. Please, please, please comment below if you think this was great. Share it if you have somebody that you think might be benefited. This and let me know your thoughts. I love to hear from you. Give me some comments below. Have a great day.